Hello, my name is Deanna Moore. I'll be playing as Salima in Ruin by Lynn Nottage.
Do you know what I was doing on that morning? I was in our garden picking the last of the sweet tomatoes. I had to put Beatrice down under the Fajapani tree because my back was giving me trouble. Forgive him? Where was Fortune? He was in town fetching a new pot. Go, I said. Go today, man, or you won't have dinner tonight. I had been after that man for a month, and finally, on that day, the man had to go and get it, a new pot. The sun was about to crest, and I had to put one more hour in before it got too hot. It was such a clear and open sky. This splendid bird, a peacock, came into our garden to taunt me. And I stooped down to call to it, whist, whist. And the shadow cut across my back.
Will Smith once told Devon Franklin, the distance between you and success isn't necessarily a yard. It's an inch. But to get to that final inch is excruciating. You have to stay committed. And I feel that. Because for years I've been telling myself that my breakthrough is right around the corner, but I must be going in circles because every turn leads to the same stuff I thought I left around the corner. I guess now I'm cornered by the stuff they told me I should have by 22. Staying committed to a dream that you can only see with your eyes closed is as hard as staying afloat in a sailboat in the middle of anxieties. I mean icebergs the size of the ones that tip the Titanic while it's raining doubt. I mean hail and waves of fear. I mean depression. I mean water continue to overpower you as you try to roll to the promised land that was promised to your hand before you were born. See, if I could talk to my Uncle Will, I would tell him that it's not that I'm not committed to the dream that is one day to be my reality. It's just the thoughts that seep in are committed too. Sometimes it's hard to think I'm great when I'm looking at someone as great as you. Hello, my name is Christina Danielle Wilson. I am located in Atlanta, Georgia, and I will be performing a snippet of a spoken word piece I wrote called Uncle Will, and I hope you guys enjoy.
I was doing just fine from the day I was born, growing up with my grandma way down on a farm, just two generations from slavery. My grandma took her own hands and she molded me. The hands was rough and hard, gentle to the touch. She taught me how she avoided slave master's clutch. Her own granddaddy black, the son of the master, go ahead and say it, you can call him a bad man. My great-great-grandpa, the son of the man. And in his mind, I gave him a great plan to make a mockery out of his family with no respect to see. It was his plan to be the grandmaster of all the children he had fathered. But my great-grandma said, oh no, you needn't bother to make a slave of me, your own blood daughter. You'd make a slave of me, your own blood daughter. So she took him to a courtroom and she won. In a white man courtroom, yes she won, yeah. Oh yeah, she took him to a courtroom and she won, yeah. In LaGrange, Georgia, yes she won, uh-huh. It was that very day that she learned to pray. I often heard her say that she learned to pray on that very day. And this is what she said: God bless the mother son that was standing my way. I'm talking about my own history. It ain't gonna be no mystery. I'm gonna share it with you, you see. Oh, yes, I am. Yes, I am.
My Uncle Bo lived in two bodies. During the daytime, he was Bo. But at night, she was Miss B. Darling. Now, my grandmother described Miss B as
two ignorant bitches, duking it out to see which one I'm gonna win the fight to speak first.
Now that I'm older, I know Miss B always won that fight.
When I first met her, it was kind of in a crisis. I needed help with the fifth grade talent show because I didn't have any rhythm. Well, I don't want to do the fifth grade talent show, but if I don't do the fifth grade talent show, then I'm going to fail fifth grade. I don't want to fail fifth grade because I knew the fifth grade talent show. Honey, just breathe. You don't have to know the words to lip sync. Hell, half the people singing the song don't know the damn words. All you got to do is feel the rhythm and the beat. Now, it is not a suggestion. It is really there. Okay? What are the words telling you? Don't tell me. Tell your feet.
If you need me, call me. No matter where you are, no matter how far.
Don't worry, baby.
Just call my name. I'll be there in a hurry. You don't have to worry.
Oh, baby, there ain't no mountain high enough.
My name is Kim Thomas, and I am from Atlanta, Georgia, and I will be doing a piece by me, Kim Thomas, called Under the Bridge. How did I get here? Why am I here? Purpose and destiny is what they say. Then how did I become homeless? How did my life end up this way? Ever since I've been here in this place, people walk by me and don't even recognize my face. My life has not been the same. People I know walk by me and don't even remember my name. How did I get here? Why am I here? Purpose and destiny is what they say. Then how did I become homeless? How did my life end up this way? Ain't always been like this. But somewhere down the line seemed like I missed. So here I sleep on a park bench. And all day long, all I see is men and women walking by with their purses and wallets clenched, with their tooted up noses as if they smell a stench. As I sleep here on a park bench, how did I get here? Why am I here? Purpose and destiny is what they say.